been an amazing discussion that's going on with all the panelists here. So I'm glad I'm part of this. So coming to your question about the leadership style, and I firmly believe that leadership is a journey that you get to being a leader, and there are a lot of things that you actually go through it that transforms you into a leader. Again, be it a male or a female. Female do have some advantages and disadvantages, and I'll discuss a bit on that. But coming to leadership styles, it's something which works today may not work tomorrow. Okay, so there's no particular style that you may have to do it. But there's a particular way of things that you would want to do. So for example, I am tough. I am tough on my on the goals and on the results that I need, be it my team or be it the organization. Because I am part of a strategic partner for this organization. So I hold the bar where I need to show where the organization is going to. So, and if that is my job responsibility, I need to ensure that I'm being tough on it. But while I'm being tough on it, doesn't mean that I am not flexible on the approach to arrive there. So and it depends situation to situation. Now, when I joined this automotive industry a couple of years back, and I was made as the manager of a team of that were all men and one woman, it was difficult because I could see that a lot of they were not accepting. There was an issue where they had some resentment to accept me as their boss, and then you and you have a task that you have to deliver along with the team. So what happens is there starts the first journey of transforming yourself into a leader, and you start using different styles or what works for that situation. So that organization that I was in, they were more about they really wanted the boss to be micromanaging them. They were used to it. And I usually like to give flexibility in terms of how you want to work, as long as we are delivering the results. And I'm always there behind the team when they need my support. So it was a journey, and I learned a lot of lessons there. One is to accept these resentments. You need to accept that fact. You can't run away from it. Two, you need to break that and go forward. Yourself, you need to take the first step to build a connection or a bond with your team so that they are accepting you and they accept your concept that you're bringing towards them. And third and more important is the fact that you have a passion and an excitement that should be contagious to your team. So if these are the things that you can manage with your team, that gives you the result, it helps you. So again, the point here is that you have a goal and you have a team and you have to deliver it. You can be tough. Being tough does not mean that you're rigid. I've got a lot of comments where they come and they say that, ma'am, you're very tough. But when we, at the end of the journey, at the end of the assignment, these same people, they come back and they tell me that it was fun to work. It was fun to work with you because this, we learned a lot of things while we did this. And it is a group learning. I learn, they learn, we all learn out of it. But you are a leader. You are there because you have a mission. You have a vision. You know how to drive your team towards it. The other important aspect is while you are being transformed into a leader, it is your responsibility that you create leaders within your team. It is important. It is important that you start, even if it's a small thing, small assignment, you need to ensure that they are leading small assignments and you are supporting them. You're letting them fail. You're letting them, stand up again and do that activity to the level of tolerance. Of course, you can manage. But that is important while we do that, because that's another level of leadership, because you can't only be the leader every time. So you need to have another leader with you. So that's important. Now, while this is being discussed about your team, you as a leader have to play an organizational role. So in an organization where you work around, you have to deal with people. So there's been an incident which I would like to. So in my first job, when I was promoted as the head of finance, and I entered into the room was full of men. And then in that case, I could suddenly imagine a thermometer of confidence, the thermometer of confidence of men were rising and mine was falling. And I was like, for a moment, I took a minute to myself to just pick up myself. And I said, I'm good. I'm doing good. I'm the best. Let's go ahead. And I went ahead in that meeting and I put a phone. Now, one which I firmly believe is women always bring a different perspective on the table. Everybody brings that. I do not say no. But women hesitate to be vocal with their different perspective. And I would urge whoever are listening to me that please be vocal when you have a different perspective. It's okay to say, to be one amongst the other. You have all others saying one thing and you can always have a voice which is a little bit different. It's And that shows your leadership skill. That shows your leadership, that shows your confidence. And the only thing that we need is that we need one person who supports that and says, yes, what she said is right. Even if he can come out and say that, you know, you could have just moderated it like this, or it may not work in the long run, but you need someone there to encourage her. And you should be that person who does the same too to others, if there's a different perspective. So that's important, that when you are there as a leader for your team, as a leader for an organization, the leadership styles may be different. It may be different at one point in time where you are under a tight or a very a serious situation, and you really need to take things in your control, and you are going to drive it and you are going to push the team and everything is under your control. That could be another situation where you want to bring in some improvements and you let your team lead it, and you step back and you let them do that and, you know, help them out when they need it. So these are different ways of the style that is there. But again, I would say I have a lot of people who have come to me, and they have told female colleagues who have come to me, and they said, you know, ma'am, it's been fun to work with you. We really look upon when we work with you, because you bring a different perspective and you do not fear to talk about it. So what I would always urge is, please be vocal. You know, if not in a bigger group, at least keep your points in front. You may be right. It's okay to be wrong. It's okay to be, if someone tells you, oh, this won't work, it's fine. But just say that, you know? Keep saying that. That is important for you. So these are my perspective on leadership styles. I would also like to add here, Prashant, I mean, I truly agree with you, and I've gone through this experience when I was being, you know, getting into a senior leadership where they stopped my promotion in one case because I would go on maternity leave. And you have to, I mean, as Gauri ma'am said, you know, you have to open the gates for others. So you have to stand there and you have to be vocal enough. But what happens is nowadays people are not vocal enough in asking those questions, but there is a subconscious bias when you interview a person. You know, the moment it's a female or a male, you have your own derailers for that female that, you know, she may go here, she may be out for 3 months. It's there in your senses, but you may not be vocal now because we have been matured enough. And I think the organizations need to take a very conscious effort to ensure that the thought process is changed. It's okay. She will go on a maternity leave and it's okay. It's fine. I mean, that acceptability level should be there, because we can't do away with this biasness, because it's going to take a long time. It's somewhere there behind us. Maybe it's culturally, or it's there as we are transforming. But that is there in the system, which female can feel it. And even a female who can feel it, they really need to step up. They need to step up. It's fine. They will be asked these questions. So you step up and you tell, yes, I will go on maternity leave. It's part of, you know, my life. So and organizations has to be prepared. How do we counterattack that? So it's very important that people don't get, especially females, don't get impacted because of this biasness, and because it's going to be there naturally sometimes, and it's going to take time to move away. And at the same time, the organization needs to be a bit more mature, consciously take effort to eradicate this. I just wanted to add to what you said, Prashant. Of course, equal pay for, you know, men and women, and as we all know, we have grown along or around it. I've seen that most of the organizations are doing that, and I can vouch that Vistion has been one of the best organizations which treat women with a lot of respect, and especially on this perspective. But while we say so, it's also as I agree with some of the panelists who mentioned here, quite a bit is on the women as well. You know, you have to first stop doubting yourself. You have to ensure that, okay, are you valuable? You know, are you putting in a lot of hours that, as someone just mentioned, into the work? I mean, if you're giving your 100% to the organization, and if you feel that you are not being paid as well, maybe equal, you may still deserve something more than a man could be doing that. It's okay to go up and, you know, talk about it. You have to break that barrier, you know, cross that bridge, go and talk about what you think you deserve basis on how much you are putting your efforts in, and don't keep judging yourself every time that, oh, you know, I couldn't attend this meeting because I had some personal assignments. I couldn't do that. I couldn't do this. And bring down your value. You know, you have to value yourself first. That is important. That's very important that we do that for us. And if you value yourself, you go up and talk it over. It may be acceptable. It may not be acceptable. Let's do our bit of it. That's what I firmly believe that that's what helps both the ways. So in case if there's any unnoticed discrimination that could be brought forward, and that can be corrected also. So we can also help the organization to do that. Yeah, and I would just want to add one concrete step is that we heard that all of the organizations are putting in a lot of policies, and you know, even government has come up with a new Companies Act that there needs to be a female director on board, right? So so that the concrete step is one is very good. We have implemented the policies. We have this regulation in place. The other part is like, you know, how do we really get them to that level? So a female, say for example, for me, I need to know that it's not because I'm getting there because there's a place for me there. I'm getting there because I deserve to be there. So that's important. So that change, a step towards, you know, effecting and implementing these policies in a way that would actually transform a woman being deserved to be sitting in that table, on the table, and not because she has a place reserved for her there. So this mindset change and actually implementing all the policies, all these organizations are having, our organizations have very beautiful policies and they're implementing it. But you know, the result of it is something that we have to ensure that we don't stop until we see the result there. And we are encouraging the right people to be there, the right females to be there, and helping them to grow through that career. So that's what I think is my perspective on this.